I always actually pictured myself moving really far away. And then the more that I, when I started looking at jobs and started looking at different places, it was just kind of really easy to kind of realize, hey, the place that I kind of grew up was actually a really good place, really good place to raise a family and get to, it was just a good place to raise a family and great place to kind of be and kind of set my home roots. So I'm Jack Belford. I'm 26 years old. I started swimming when I was 8 or 9 for the club, and then I swam all the way through high school and swam at Wabash College. So I'm working in sales for a supply chain consulting firm. Haven't moved very far, obviously. I'm still living in Carmel. Just bought a house in Carmel, so raising my family there.
Exciting.
I would say that my first memories are swimming at the Rivi. My family, I was born in Indy. I lived around Meriden Kessler, and so we were members of the Rivi, and so we swam there growing up. And then when we moved to Carmel, we had our neighborhood pool that we always went to, and we had a ton of family friends that were actually members of the club that were also members of our neighborhood pool and lived in our neighborhood. And so that's kind of how we got into swimming, was through them and through just kind of being around people that were really good at swimming. And my family is very competitive, and so we really didn't like that we weren't the best swimmers in the pool and things like that. And so that's kind of my first memories of swimming, I would say.
It's fun. I've heard this story from a couple people now about starting with summer league and neighborhood swimming and wanting to be good. And
yes.
So
not enjoying getting third or fourth or
Yep. So figuring out, okay, those people that are finishing ahead of me, what are they doing? And Carmel Swim Club has been a common denominator on all of this.
So my sister, so Carolyn started, I'm trying to think, so she's a year younger. She started it would have been a year or two before I did.
Okay.
And so I was sitting in the stands. I was at some meet it was at the high school. And I just kind of looked at my parents and said, I'm sick of sitting in the pool or sitting in the stands watching her swim. I'm going to do it.
Nice.
And so then that was just kind of like a one day I just decided, and I think they signed me up the next week.
Perfect.
And so I started swimming, and I was not very good, and Carolyn was really good. And so that was tough. And so it was one of those things where Carolyn might have been, she was younger, but she was in a group ahead of me. And so it really pushed me to try to be better. I used to joke that because it would have been Lauren at the time, they used to joke that I looked like I was drowning as I was swimming, which I guess that didn't really change as I got older, but that's for other reasons.
I think you had your own technique and you had your own style, but
I had my own style.
That's important. That's a good way to go through life with your own.
I would say definitely time management.
Yeah.
Getting up in the morning swimming, I mean, it was definitely starting in sixth or seventh grade, getting up at 4:45, 5 o'clock in the morning to get to morning practice, and then you're swimming until 6:15 in at night. You have to really figure out times where 10-15 minutes is enough time to get a lot of work done. And so that's something that a lot of people don't necessarily get to experience that until they're in the real world. And you're working and you have 15 minutes between meetings or 10 minutes between meetings. And people kind of take that time as kind of, hey, I'm going to just kind of relax and hang out for 10 minutes where they could be doing something else to be productive. And so you end up where if you have a day of meetings, you end up where you get more done than a lot of other people because you take that time as time to get things done. And so at the end of the day, people are kind of looking around like, I didn't get anything done other than sit in meetings. And you're like, well, we had some time to do it.
Yeah,
and it's just what you made of that time.
Absolutely.
Listen to the coaches.
Mm-hmm.
That's the easiest and easiest thing to say, not necessarily the easiest thing to do all the time, especially when it comes to like technique and things like that. I think that the coaches have your best, I mean, they always have your best interest in mind. And no matter what, it might make you, if it's a change in technique, it might make you slower for a few weeks, but in the long run, it's going to pay off. The other thing is just kind of embrace it and enjoy the moments with your friends, because these are the people that you're going to hang out with for the rest of your life.
Yeah. Might end up in your wedding one day.
Yes.
Very cool.
3 or 4 of them. I'd say just go for it. I don't think, I mean, it's a group of people that have a passion for a sport like no other. I mean, I wasn't involved in any other club, mm-hmm. or any other club, so I don't know what the difference is between Carmel and Fishers or whatnot, but I would say that, I mean, the coaches have a passion, and the people, the parents, the athletes, everyone has a passion for a sport that's unlike anything else. And so I'd say that you might as well jump in and go for it. Give it 6 months, give it a year, see how you like it. If you don't like it, it's okay. But, I mean, more than likely you're going to end up enjoying yourself. Yeah, I would definitely say the Fort Lauderdale trip, mm-hmm. or the Nashville meet. Both meets were always a blast. We only did Fort Lauderdale once, but everyone, like, there's a picture on Facebook that's got like 400 comments on it that has everyone that went, and people just every once in a while just kind of comment on it like, hey everyone, how's it going? And so just because everyone was so close, everyone enjoyed the trip so much. Yeah. It was, I mean, not just the swim meet, but also we stayed there and swam for a couple of days after the meet, and everyone got really close, and I think that kind of set the tone for the club moving forward, just to really kind of dive in and really enjoy each other. Mm-hmm. I think that, I mean, when I was in high school, I think that the club was going through kind of a transformation. And so that kind of, I think that kind of really set the tone for the beginning of it.